Let A be the matrix 5 minus 2, 6 minus 2, and X be the vector 2, 3. And we'll try to compute the following. A times X, A squared times X, and A to the 1000 times X. If you look at part A and part B of this question, they are quite straightforward. You can just carry out the multiplication. But if you look at part C, do we really want to compute A to the 1000? Assuming that we're doing this by hand. So let's see what we can do here. Maybe we can get lucky. So let's first compute A times X. So if we write down A and X, this is what we have. And so the first entry will be 5 times 2 plus minus 2 times 3. And in the second entry will be 6 times 2 plus minus 2 times 3. And that will be, so 10 minus 6 is 4, and 12 minus 6 is 6. Okay, so that's A times X, that's part A. Now what about part B? Let's work out what A squared is. A squared is 5 minus 2, 6 minus 2 times 5 minus 2, 6 minus 2. And that will give us this matrix here. And so A squared times X is 8 and 12. Now, it doesn't look like that we can write down a formula for A to the 1000 right away. But if you look at 4, 6, that's simply 2 times X. And if you look at 8, 12, that's 4 times X. The fact that A times X is 2 times X means if you multiply both sides again by A, you get A squared equal 2 times AX, which again gives you 2 times 2 times X, right? Because A times X is 2 times X, and that's 2 squared X. Now you can repeat this and get that if K is a positive integer, then this is simply 2 to the K times X. So we can write down A to the 1000 times X to be 2 to the 1000 times 2, 3. And that would be a good enough answer for this question. So in this case, we got lucky. Because if you try to compute A to the 1000 times 1, 1, we don't get anything this nice. Because A times 1, 1 is simply 3, 4. And 3, 4 is not a scalar multiple of 1, 1. So this trick here will not apply to the vector 1, 1. But is there something that we can do here? It turns out that, yes, there is. And I'm going to do this by writing A differently. We're going to let P be the matrix 2, 1, 3, 2. D be the matrix 2, 0, 0, 1. If you compute the inverse of P, you get this. And A can be written as P times D times P inverse. This is something that you can check. Now, how does that help us? So let's look at A squared. So A squared is P times D times P inverse times P times D times P inverse again, right? So this is A and this is A. P inverse times P, that's the identity. So this, after you simplify, will be P D squared, because this has become the identity. So I have D times I times D, that gives me D squared times P inverse. And what about A cubed? A cubed is A times A squared. And so this is P times D times P inverse times A squared is now this thing over here, P times D squared times P inverse. Again, this becomes the identity. So what we get is P times D cubed times P inverse. And as you can see, if we continue in this fashion, we can deduce that A to the K is P times D to the K times P inverse. D is a diagonal matrix. When you take power of the diagonal matrix, you simply take the powers of the diagonal entries. So for example, if I want to look at what D to the fifth power is, I just take the diagonal entries to the fifth power, and that will give us 32001. And so if you want to know what a to the 1000 is, well, it's simply p times d to the 1000 times p to the minus 1. And this will be p times 2 to 1000, 0, 0, 1, p inverse. So with this, you can easily compute a to 1000 times whatever vector that you have. But the question is, how did I come up with p and d? What I've done here is just I gave you these two matrices. I haven't shown you how to obtain p and d. Going into answering this question will take us to the topic of eigenvalues and eigenvectors.